Hello everyone and welcome to NagGraphics. We are discussing the chapter of transforming objects, and till now we have discussed three types of transformations, which are moving, rotating and reflecting the objects. And in this video we will discuss about scaling. Scaling means increasing or decreasing the size of the object. Let's check out its available options. First of all, select the object you want to scale. Then we go to the control panel options of transform. Here we can enter the width and the height values of the object. You can choose the reference point from here. Selecting reference point for scaling would precisely mean that the referred point is gonna stay constant and any change you make will affect the rest of the part of the object. Say if I want to increase the width of the object by 200 points and if I select center reference point, that will mean that center point is gonna be constant and increase of 200 points will be done on the left and the right side of the object equally. Like here in the width column, if I increase it by 200 points with center reference point, notice that the 200 points of increment is applied equally to both sides because we chose the center reference point. But if you select, let's say, the upper left corner, then that point of the object is going to be constant and the increment of 200 points will be on the right side only. Like here you can notice the increment is on the right side only. We also have a specified tool for scaling here in the tools panel. Select it and you can freely drag the selected object to scale it up or down. Here also we can select any reference point by simply clicking anywhere and then drag, and it will then scale according to that reference point. To scale by entering values in the scales dialog box, you can double click this button, which will automatically make the reference point to be the center of the shape. Or for opening dialog box in respect to any point of reference, press Alt key and then click anywhere. Now let's discuss the options here. Here we have the option of entering the percentage value only. Uniform means it will increase or decrease the size proportionately on all sides. And if you don't want to scale proportionately, you can choose non-uniform option and set the values as desired. Option of scale corners asks whether to scale up or down the corner radius according to the scaling values entered by you. This option is applicable to the shapes having round corners, like here we have, and it is always good to take this option. Let's do a practical. Here I select this shape and we can see in the transform panel, its corner radius value is 50 points. If you don't have transform panel here, you can open it by going to the window menu and select transform. Right now I am unticking this option, and now if I scale this shape up or down, the radius value is gonna remain same. If I check this option and then scale it up or down, the radius value will set proportionately. Likewise, we have the option of scale stroke and effect. It will scale the stroke size proportionately. Generally, this option is kept unchecked, and as you will progress further into the course of learning Illustrator, you will know the good reasons why it is kept unchecked. Then here we have the copy button, which will make a duplicate copy as per the set values while preserving the original one. Like here I set the uniform scaling to 10% and press copy. It will make a new copy with that size. So this is all about the scale option, and in the next video we will discuss about the last type of transformation, which is shearing. Thanks for watching NagGraphics and subscribe to this channel for more upcoming tutorials.